to the point of no return. How long do you need? Yeah, I'm glad I cut that lip off. I'm not sure about this lip because I might be able to leverage some of that. I don't know. But this panel is going to be a lot smoother than trying to, you know, cut like a groove in here. Plus, it gives me lots of fiberglass area to mold to. I'm going to put that up there. Yeah. So, yeah, that's going to work out really good. Nobody'll know it's not a 73. It'll be a chrome bumper. Yeah, somebody was saying, man, they could drive their Nova through my gap. You're right, you could. That's just not a gap. That's a chunk. You know what was shitty is when I first painted this car, I had my doors all nicely aligned. I even block sanded like the door and the panel together and everything lined up beautifully, and then I put weather stripping on it. As soon as I put the weather stripping on it, it wouldn't shut all the way. So what I learned was I need to move this over, but this was 50 years old and I put a crowbar on it and I couldn't move it, so I kind of left it just not aligning. But this time around, oh my gosh, I guess what I'll do is get some PB Blaster, come from the inside of this where it mounts, because I don't know if you could tell, but I almost stripped it trying to get that sucker to break loose, and it would not break loose. So yeah, when it's doesn't have the, yeah, it just needs to come in a little bit. Just that pin needs to be moved over just a hair. Anyway, yeah, I've crossed the point of no return on this. I cut the lip off. I'm going to panel bond this seam on. Then I'll clean it with acetone. It's not actually panel bonded yet. I'm just making sure it's going to line up. Like, this side's good. This side extrudes too much, so I'll have to cut it a little bit here, and I'll figure it out.